Gruza against Lucina. Lucinda. Damele un forward smash. Okay, and we're just gonna go for it. Okay, and the buzz just like going in right now. Wait a minute. Why does it look like this game is going a lot faster than any of the other ones? Like the speed was turned up. 0% sin on the buzz right now. 50% on E in disadvantage.
Oh yeah, this is something that's like a complete 180. Like if you watched last week Dill versus the buzz, you're thinking Rob and Rosa, they were just going at it like over and over and over again.
Yeah.
So now you have DeBuzz Rosa, who apparently is super aggressive, versus E. And like that, you can already expect like ridiculous aggression.
Oh, for
sure.
So
yeah, they're just going right at it.
Look at this. And now the tables have turned already. 86% in on DeBuzz. It seems like E just won one neutral exchange or turned around the disadvantage state. And he's able to put DeBuzz off the stage with 100%. And those are the things that you really have to pay attention to. It's not just the percentages, but where are the characters on the screen? Where is your opponent? How is he getting back? Mm-hmm. That's how you have to kind of like look at this game in order to secure stocks and be good, be great. E doing a good job. That was the first time DeBuzz has hit him since that first kind of burst in the beginning of the match, which is good. Okay. He's going to run up and grab that up air. Still very strong. Very strong. You cannot mess around with that. Got some raid sin on that Luma, so you will die. Back throw, gonna put E off the stage. How do you get back up B? Oh, that's surprising. The Buzz opted, instead of like trapping him, to just go to the middle of the stage, kind of giving up stage control. Seems to be a mistake. And that neutral air, so good. Cromeroy, more like a combo move. Yeah, for Lucina and Marth,
kills.
You will get deleted.
Yeah, absolutely.
You will get deleted. And just like that, Mr. Eason at 110 on his first stock, keeping DeBuzz out, creating this wall, ironically.
Yeah. And now you see that like things are beginning to slow down a bit.
Yeah.
Because like, he's like, I'm going to hang on to my lead. Rosa, like, she may be not in her former grace, but, you know, she still hits really hard. So you have to be careful. Like, Luma is still a, like, force. Like, that down air, oh my lord. Okay, yeah. Solo Rosa up smash, not gonna do it. Not enough rage, and Battlefield just too tall.
And that's something DeBuzz has been good with.
All right, yep, all
right. Right as I was about to say it. That's something DeBuzz has been really good with since Smash 4, reacting to your jumps or your hits on his shield with up smash.
DeBuzz had mentioned something to Dill and I last week, saying that, like, there's this new thing that when she does smash attacks, Luma will kind of, like, rush to a set position of like where he should be when she does it. So like, okay, when she did that up smash, Luma's like, oh, I gotta go. I'm gonna go. I'm just gonna book it, you know, and just like goes and smacks you.
I need to be there for this smash move.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, oh, I'm late, you know. But all right,
this is ugly. Okay, good job by E, not exhausting his resources. Still had that jump.
Seeing a repeat of like the first and second stock now. DeBuzz on his last. If he can take this stock now, it'll be even up.
How do you get away from this? Jump has no iframes, so as soon as you jump from the ledge, you are vulnerable. So how do you get away from that? You got somebody sitting at roll distance and neutral get up distance.
Okay. Oh,
bro,
you gotta tilt those shields, man.
Yeah, man.
Especially if you're gonna hold it that long.
Yes.
Like the moment you hold it, it's like if you're not tilting it, then you're asking for it to be poked. In this game, oh my god, everyone's shield is Swiss cheese.
Yes. And I don't know, I kind of, if it was more consistent, I'd really, really like it. But I like it. I like the fact that you can't just sit and shield and do whatever you want. Nonetheless.
Okay. So I really like that Dancing Blade that E did. He did it far enough where when he did the fake out, he was going to be outside of grab range.
Uh-huh.
And DeBuzz was aware of that. So he just, you know, went back to neutral for regular interaction.
Okay. Gonna keep, and although E kind of got hit in that exchange, he was able to keep full stage control. Has DeBuzz at the ledge. Okay, just gonna run up and grab DeBuzz. Brave. Okay, up tilt gonna put him right back in the bad situation. No resources. Gonna land on that platform. Jab. Gonna do it. Gonna put him off stage. It's good for DeBuzz. Okay, nice. Just gonna fare right out of that jab.
Whoa.
Whoa. He wanted the slide cancel forward tilt. I know it. He did not want dash attack there.
Yeah, but he's going to get hit by that Lunar Landing.
Yes,
it's
Lunar
been a while.
Landing.
It's been a while.
Okay, good job by E. Getting, getting rid of the Luma and the up B out of shield. Not gonna do it yet. The Buzz has a second chance at life. How do you make it back to the stage? No Luma.
Okay.
Not dead yet. We're going to have a Luma before he gets back to the stage. This is good.
Yeah.
That was risky. That was risky. The Buzz bet a lot with that one. He thought E was going to immediately act out and react to his jump. So he threw out a hitbox to kind of stuff him out first. But E was very patient. He understood the situation. And he was able to get that fair to punish that Nair. Because okay. That Nair is really good. But in the air, it has a lot of like and like. Okay. Or FAF. The FAF is really big on that move. So,
for those who don't know what FAF or FAF is, the first actionable frame. So how the sooner you can act out of a move.
Yes. And some moves auto-cancel really well when you hit the ground. But their FAF is, like, horrible. For instance, Sheik Nair. Like, if you Nair with Sheik off the stage and you don't have a jump, you're probably going to die. But if you Nair and land on the ground, you can act out almost immediately. So, it's a little example. But the Buzz opting to switch characters. We see the Olimar.
Going Ollie.
And then we see a stage switch. We are at Town and City.
Yeah. He had gotten rid of Lila and Kalos.
Uh-huh.
So, this is his counter pick to Town. So, Town has a really large... really switched it up from the switch from Smash 4 to Ultimate, and now the Blast Zones are massive.
Uh-huh.
So I'm kind of curious. So it has like an FD, FD feel to it.
Yes.
During the in-between transitions, like right now. Except the stage is like hella wide. I'm pretty sure it's bigger than FD. And yeah, we just gotta see how he's gonna do it fair with this. Just because like you need to be fat. You wanna in this sort of layout, you wanna be able to juggle them.
For sure, for sure. You know? Especially when there's no platforms and your juggle game is really good, you wanna take advantage of that. Just like that, you can see the Buzz not trying to press anything, not trying to take any extra damage. He understood that he lost advantage. So he's going to go to the other side of the stage. E going to throw him off the stage. But that Monique coming in clutch right now, getting him off that platform. Because although those side platforms, similar to Kalos, can be a safe haven for some characters to retreat back to the stage. Ooh, forward smash! That fire Pikmin going to do it for the Buzz.
Ooh.
Dancing Blader.
What lead? What lead?
Exactly.
We're just doing stock matches, 0%. You know, Smash 4 up in here.
Let's just restart, you know?
Yeah.
That was a good first stock. Let's do it again.
Yeah. It's like, you know how we started the game? I want to do that.
Yeah, let's start it again. But as I was saying, like, with those platforms at the side, although they can be, like, really good as far as, like, characters retreating back to the stage, if your opponent is really, like, patient, he can keep you there.
Yeah, definitely. Okay.
Just like this, you see the Buzz kind of feel... When you're facing a swordie and you're stuck on that platform, you almost feel trapped, like suffocated.
You actually can't move.
Like, it's insane.
It's like, do I go high and then, like, risk exhausting my jump and then being in an even worse situation? Mm-hmm. Like, oh, Lord, what do I do?
Yep, you definitely got to think.
And that platform is, like, right by the ledge, so you're just like, I don't go off stage. That's a bad idea.
It's like, do I come out of shield and get hit with somebody's back here?
Anyway, so percent's pretty even right now.
Yes.
Both of these characters are strong enough where they can just kill by accident. And, yeah, we see that the Buzz is actually just giving up a lot of ground and just, like, handing it to E, where he's just like, yeah, he's running to the edge to get away from him, but then, like, you're putting all the stage behind E.
Ooh, and that forward tilt going to do it. But before he died, he actually had two Moniques, which pretty prime for him. Yeah, he had two Moniques in the pocket.
He was ready to kill.
Yeah, but he wasn't able to use them. Nonetheless, he probably was trying to get a white Pikmin. But nonetheless, 135 sitting on Mr. E right now. No rage on the Buzz, so he's not as scared, but still, you still got to be scared. You still got a Monique on deck.
Yeah, but now he can just like definitely go for a grab. So if he has the purple and the blue, then you know he can literally just like mix up how he wants to do that approach just seal out this last stock. Although,
purple and the blue, as you said,
he is building so much. So much of a lead, so much extra credit. 80
for sure.
Damage? And he's still not dead. Thanks, Town and City. Ooh.
Wow. I'm pretty upset about that one, actually.
Upbeat right into it. He just, like, held that hitbox out and was just like, you will two-frame yourself.
Yeah, that was a really good place.
Quit two-framing yourself. Two-framing yourself.
Yo, that was messed up. The way he threw Monique off the stage just now, he's like, yo, you're too heavy, B. I can't have you.
Oh, my God. All of that damage, DeBuzz closing this gap extremely fast. Although his back is still against the wall.
For sure.
If he loses this, he's going to loser's bracket.
Okay, I'm going to the other side with a Monique on deck. He didn't want to let go of the Monique.
Ooh, that's it.
And that Nair. And not for nothing, that was kind of quick work. That was a quick match. By DeBuzz standards, that was a really fast match. Usually DeBuzz's matches go for a little bit longer. But you can see Mr. E adapted very well. In the beginning of that match, he was kind of getting beat up. DeBuzz had a little bit of momentum going in. But E kind of stopped it. And not only stopped it, but picked up his own momentum. I was able to secure that. That looked really good on E's part. I actually played him in bracket earlier today. And like he looked really good. Really good.
Yeah, so fantastic stuff for E. He's going to be moving on to winner's finals.